Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 42 of my Resonant Rise Let's Play. And today, I want to continue on building the arena. So, yeah, as you guys can see, I did myself a little bit of work between the episodes, mainly to make this look a bit nicer. I'm not sure if I did this on camera, but I made the throne right here. I think it looks quite nice, actually. And basically, this exact spot is where the people will land, so that's quite nice. I added these chisel blocks because, well, in contrast with this red carpet, I had some people suggesting me that this color looked a little bit better than just the plain stone. And I must say, I agree with them, so yeah, that's quite nice. Also added the fences down here and added the stuff right here. And I added this computer right here just to say, like, welcome to gorgeous work in progress battle arena. Pretty easy, so yeah, nothing too fancy, but it's just a little bit of a warning or, you know, information panel for people that just come into this age but don't know what's up here. But I think most people already know that. So today I want to take care of a couple of things. One of the problems that I'm having is that it keeps spawning a nether portal here, and I am not exactly sure how I want to fix this. But I think what I could do is simply move this down, and then it wouldn't have a valid platform to spawn on, I think. But other than that, I wouldn't have any real idea on how to fix that. So what I think I'll do is probably do that between the episodes, so that shouldn't be too hard. And let's see, quickly fix it what I got right now. Yeah, pretty much every time someone relogs onto the server, this thing pretty much resets itself, so yeah, that's quite annoying. So let's see. And also, water blocks don't really matter like that. So yeah, that's quite an issue. So yeah, today I'm thinking that I want to start working on the locker room for the, well, the rooms and such, and pretty much make it like, yeah, just tell you guys how everything works. So let me get started with that. Okay, so let's get started. So what the first thing that I probably need to build is like sort of a entrance thingy right here that basically gives all the information and decides like which team you should go on. So let's see how I want to set that up. What I think I'll do is probably extend this out a little bit, and I'll make that look a little bit better soon too. Don't worry about that. And then make it like, just doing some stuff right here right now, but always nice to mess around a bit. And let's see, builders want. Bit further. Nice, I guess. And then what I can do is pretty much make some sort of glass window right here eventually. And pretty much the arena will be sitting right here, like in the middle of this massive area. And then the two locker rooms will be extended into each of these two sides. At least that's what I got in mind currently. So I think this will work out quite nicely, hopefully. So let's see. Also get myself a bit more obsidian. Just a bit more. But that shouldn't be an issue again. Yeah. Let's also get some fence. What are those? Carpenters. I also, like I said, made these so they store 256 instead of just 56 between the episodes. So yeah, that should, or 64 between the episodes. So that is quite nice too. So let's see. What I can do is make like right there, like sort of a ticket sort of thingy, which will be basically displaying all the info and yeah, all that kind of stuff. Maybe I have like a monitor in the back right here. So yeah, I think this will be quite nice. And then extend this up. And yeah, I think I'll have to change it out a bit with the idea I had with the glass window thingy. But let me also turn this on. Like maybe even have it like make some stairs up here so people can actually, you know, watch it from up there. And I think it's actually quite a good idea, to be honest. Let's see, red rule. I want everything to be basically gray, red, or black, as in obsidian. So I think this will be quite nice. Then also right here. And then let's see, do this. Get some carpenter blocks. Put these up there. Sort of like that. Cool. Then what I'll probably do is also make them point like right here. That's not even close to what I wanted. That isn't either. Any easy way to do that? I guess not. Obsidian. Maybe even what I can do is, let's see if this works. Get myself some normal carpenter blocks. I'm not sure if this actually works, but, oh, not right there. Can I put this like right there and get my carpenter's hammer out? Can I make it like... Oh yeah, I can. Nice. That's what I wanted. Nice. And then make it like there. And tap this off. Awesome. I think this will look quite nicely. Then what I can do is probably get some clear glass. Don't need that much. I think a stack will do. Fill these spots in. The back won't be clear glass, but I'll probably put the monitor, like I said, in there. Should be quite nice. Yeah, I think that will be quite nice. Let me quickly get a monitor going. Quickly teleport to my base. Oop. Don't glitch up. Ah, I'm glitching. Let's see. Computer craft. How many monitors do I have? Monitors. 10. That won't be enough. Just not enough. Oh! I didn't mean to craft a stack. Well, okay, I guess. A bit of an issue, but oh well. Might as well have some extra then, I guess. So yeah, that's nice. Then, whoop! Turn back into mage. Man, this thing is awesome. And, yeah. Like I said, whenever I do that, this thing here spawns right here. So, yeah. You're very annoying. And I have no idea why that happens either, so that's maybe even the strangest thing. Yeah, this will look nice. Oh. And I should really fix that hole in there. Oh well. Let me... what I can do is probably put this like right here. And let me very quickly make a very test program. So let's see. M is rep peripheral peripheral dot and then the back then M dot clear. I really can't type today. Then M dot write testing monitor. This should be enough. Let's quickly restart it. And what did I do wrong? And it's wrap peripheral the back clear and write testing monitor. What did I do wrong? Let me quickly get this going. Ah, there we go. I just messed it up a little, switched these two around. Apparently I shouldn't have done that. What I can also do is probably scale, make it like scale 3. So let's see how that works, or how that looks. And it's failing at 4. Scale 2 maybe then. Okay, yeah, I shouldn't mess too much with this thing. Let me just remove this. It works for now, and it doesn't have to be any fancier for now, so yeah, that's good. So, yeah, this is the quite nice part. So now what I can do is also probably make it up to right there. Fill this in. Break this. Bit more. Awesome. Builder's wand. Oh wait. You can't builder's wand water blocks. That's right. Awesome. And then always ward them just in case these things are well, in case fire happens right here. So I want them to be warded. Awesome. And I'll clear this portal off in a minute or two. And then what I can probably add is what I'll think will look quite nice. Make it like, extend this 2 blocks on each side. Let's see. Then what I can do is get myself a few more of... Well, what I probably need to do is replace these with carpenter stairs. So let's get 2 stacks of carpenter stairs and put some of that other junk away. Which I don't need. And I'll probably... what I'll probably do then is break this too. And this one. Make these like right there, right there. Then I can extend this if 2 blocks on each side. For now at least. And pretty much make it so that this thing will look nice. So that's 1, 2, 3. That's 1, 2, 3. Then I should put this right there. Or not. Oops. Damn you, math. These stairs are annoying to place. That's one fact. Then quickly also do it right there. Okay, that's quite nicely. Then get myself some more obsidian going. Normal obsidian. And get my chisel out. I hope you guys actually enjoy me building this because, well, I normally don't do such massive projects. And I really like to give it a chance because, well, you know, it looks quite nice in my opinion. And I've never, you know... I want to try out a few different things because I, like I said, normally don't do this kind of stuff. So, yeah, I would really appreciate you guys' feedback on my any of my videos, really. But especially when I'm building big stuff like this because, well, yeah. It's all difficult and random and I just do what how I build. So, yeah, that's why I normally don't really plan out too much of stuff. Just a few to-do lists and, you know, don't plan like I want to be like that or like that. But just like, yeah, I want to build that. Okay, let's record and I'll see what it turns out to look like. Awesome. So basically, eventually, the arena will be back here. And we'll have like one massive window around this thing where people can actually just watch the arena if they're interested. Like maybe make a big balcony some sorts back here. I should actually be able to do that. Shouldn't be too big of a deal. Like, tiny balcony. Not too big. That's quite nice. And then I'll probably also make like a little railing on this side. Like I did on right there. With the normal stone and such. So yeah, I think this will be quite nice actually. So let me quickly do this and I'll be right back. Okay, I think this looks actually quite nice like this. What I quickly did is I made myself the precision shears, which are two unstable ingots and two angel blocks. But pretty much these things allow you to instantly right click break any blocks and they will be teleported into your inventory, or at least any block that can be broken with a pickaxe. So yeah, it's actually quite nice because, well, when I'm flying like this and it takes ages for obsidian to break, but what I can do is simply shift right click and it will be broken anyway. So yeah, that's actually quite useful. So imagine like eventually there will be clear glass like sitting right here. I might as well do it just for the purpose of showing it to you guys. Like eventually, I'm not sure if I will be using simply this glass or any other type of glass, but something along these lines. Then probably also right here. Which I think looks quite nicely, and then probably break this, or make this like this. Yeah, so imagine like the arena will be right here, and people can simply, if they want, walk up here, and simply watch the entire match happening. And yeah, I think this will be quite interesting to actually see. So, what I think I'll do now is start working on the actual, well, not the actual arena yet, but pretty much the locker rooms, or maybe even the actual arena, I'm not really sure yet. Because if I make the actual arena, I can pretty much shape the other things around it, which will be pretty cool, I think. So, yeah, what I think I'll do is I'll start working with the main arena now. For the arena, I will need myself a couple of things, and one of which is simply a modular force field setup. If you guys have watched one of my previous videos that I uploaded, which is pretty much a concept for how I want to... or a concept on how to use the, a concept for how I want my dome to pretty much look like. And I think this will be quite nice. So let's see, modular force fields. There we go. So I'll need one of these, and I need a few energy tablets. Let's make 10, just because I can. Let's see, one Corsian driver. One Fortron capacitor, one force field projector, and that's all I really need, I think. Yeah, I don't need any of these. Then I need the sphere upgrade, and I need myself a bunch more of these. So one sphere upgrade, a bunch of speed upgrades. 10 probably won't be enough. And I'm out of steel. Oh, well, that's to be expected, actually. Let's see. What else do I need? The dome upgrade, which is one of the things that I also need. Well, pretty much power. How do I actually want to power this? I was thinking of simply using windmills because, well, I might as well. So yeah, I think this wouldn't be such an issue. Let's see, wind, mills. I got like that, and I can very easily craft myself more if I wanted. So yeah, that's quite cool. So let me quickly head back to the H. And oh yeah, right, it's nighttime now. It only shows the actual effect of eternal day if you are in the arena. But now I need to think how I want this thing to lay out. First of all, I will need the Corsian driver pretty much at this same height, but I will need to be a specific range from this thing. And I think that if I would make it like a, either a 15 by 15 or 25 by 25, and I think a 25 will work quite nice, radius it is. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. This will be the exact spot of my projector. Awesome. Now what I can also do is extend this thingy a little bit so I can actually have the space to build on this thing and not mess up too much. Nice. Then put the Fortron capacitor can be like right there. and the coercion driver will be, yeah. Also, not too extremely far for this, but I do need it to be like pretty close, because otherwise I will need to use a wireless system in this age, which actually shouldn't be too much of an issue. I might as well do that, I think. Let's see. Got myself two of those dimensional transceivers. I got one already. Let's make one more. Okay, it's quickly crafting that up. I shouldn't get that in a minute. I might as well like put it maybe on the roof or something like that. Or will that look quite ugly? Yeah, I think that won't look... Darn it! Dumb nether portals. Yeah, I think that wouldn't look too nicely if I would put it like exactly on there. So, since it does need a plain sight of view, what I'll probably do is like extend it from here to the side or something. Like, do I have any more bricks? Like, get four more stacks. This shouldn't be an issue of space. No, it isn't. Yet. One. Two, three, and four. Nice. And then I'll just simply extend it to here. It doesn't have to be too far, but, you know, I don't mind people seeing a little bit of how this actually works. I want it to be like, you know, it's for everyone to see and pretty much don't have to be anything secret into the build because, well, you know, everyone has a little bit of a share into what will be this final build. So yeah, I think this will be quite nice. So what I can do is then extend this platform a bit and put the cables down. And I will need quite a lot of power, really. So let's... I can do one right there, so then also right here. I said right there. Like that, and then can I... can actually do that. Bit of a waste, but not an issue. And wow, that's precisely enough. So let's see, what I can do is simply hook up like this right here. Make it a new channel. I'll call this arena power. Add it to a private channel. And then send power. Nice. Then quickly get myself all the windmills that I need. Windmills. Yeah, the issue is that these things don't stack properly, so that's sad. But I guess I'll have to live with that. And does this work? Huh, this actually works. I thought it wouldn't work like that. Oh well. Let's quickly make myself a little bit more space before I can actually need to wrap up this episode. Put this. Put it all away. Myself the rest of the windmills. Do we have enough space for this? I do. Nice. Well, I think this doesn't look that nice. So what I'll do is simply like this. So I actually use like all everything that I am currently having. And then alternate it. Okay, so this should be producing, well, I don't even know, but it's a lot of power. Let's keep it at that. So let's see. Now I can actually start working on the dome for this thing, which is pretty much the only thing that this thing will be powering. So this will be in here. This will be in here for now. Dome module. The coercion driver will also need to be, well, now because I don't even need this power right here, I can simply... put this like right next to it and this too, and then get the other dimensional transceiver that I just made. Arena power and receive power, And it is actually receiving power. This doesn't have to be any different. This can be on this thing foo. And I will probably need to change that up though. Then I need, do I have any of those modules? Translation module. Yep. Just for now. Awesome. And let's see what happens if I turn this thing on. These things need to be up. It should, yeah. It's currently only producing one block because, well, it doesn't have much more yet. But eventually, I will make it have the entire dome. So, first, before I can actually do this, I will need myself a bunch more steel to actually get all these upgrades. So, crap, I don't have it told in my system how to make it steel. One sec, guys. Okay, I quickly bought myself some, some of those, or some steel. And apparently I already had a bunch of these in my system, so that's nice. But I do probably need myself a few more translation modules, so let's get those. Nice. Then what I'll need is probably a bunch more speed modules, like, let's say, a stack. I do need to make these, though. And then I should make a stack. And I think that is all I need for now. So let's try it out. Make it into my H. Of course, we got a nether portal. And it's raining. Nice. Not really. But yeah, what can I do about it? And then let's put these in here. So this is speed up a little bit. Then put like half of this in here. And then I'll put the rest in here again. Because I need this thing to be having a lot of power. Then put the translations in here. And let's say 24 skill modules. How will this look? Oh, that's almost perfect. A bit too high though. And I'm having power issues. But that's not an issue yet. let's see. Let's turn this up a little bit down. And skill modules is, I believe, almost perfect. So, yeah, that's quite nice. Imagine this being the dome of my arena. Or maybe, can I extend this? Yeah, I need it to be one block bigger, I think. One skill module bigger. And I can put this one or two down. Yeah, like that. Imagine, like, this should be the exact center. Yes, it is. Wow, awesome. This is like perfectly. But imagine like being a glass wall right up to here. And this is the entire dome of the arena. Which will be quite big. But I think also quite worth it in the end. Because it will look amazing. So, yeah. I think this would be a good wrapping up point for this episode, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Probably between the episodes I will pretty much make this thing work how I wanted it to. And tweak it a little bit. Make this all work, well, how I wanted it to. And yeah, just make it all work nice, actually. So, thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a rating. And I hope to see you guys all next time.